Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, we're going to talk about how many rejections can you get on Merch by Amazon before they close your account. This was inspired by a very active thread in my Merch by Amazon Facebook group, which of course is linked to in the description below. So check that out if you're not already in there. I'm going to share some highlighted posts from this active thread. I'm also going to share some of my personal feedback based on experience and based on what I've seen people say in the group over the years. So why don't we get started? Quick reminder, take advantage of my free weekly print on demand giveaway. Two winners are going to be selected. This week is a special giveaway too, because in addition to getting a license to everything you see behind me, Merch Titans, Merch Ninja, All Sunsets, and Bubble Scout, each winner is going to get a free enrollment into a course of their choosing from my ryansmethod.com school. So make sure you guys enter. It's giveaway number 50, so we're doing it big. Also, the giveaway link is in the description. While you're down there, you might want to check out the Amazon Merch Facebook group, because we're going to be referencing that in today's video. All right, so this is what somebody posted on the group. They posted an account termination notice. Hopefully you guys never receive one of these, but why don't we just read it real quick? This comes from the Merch by Amazon team. Dear content creator, we are contacting you about your Merch by Amazon account and the designs you have submitted for sale. Unfortunately, we found violations of our content policy and the Merch by Amazon services agreement. Per our agreement, your account has been terminated. All royalty payments will be withheld, and we have taken down all designs associated with your account. If you would like to appeal this decision, please contact us with any relevant information pertaining to your account status and add a description of past policy violations here. You are not permitted to create a new Merch by Amazon account. Best regards, the Merch by Amazon team. Yeah, so when you get this, your heart pretty much drops. You do not want to see one of these. And this person specifically that received this email was very active in the Facebook group. So we're going to read through some of their comments, their threads, and somebody actually did their due diligence and dug up an old post from the person that shared this. By the way, everybody's going to remain anonymous just because it's a private Facebook group, so I don't have anybody's permission. But so I blurred out the names, but it's still good for discussion and whatnot. So again, plugging the Facebook group, there will be a link in the description in case you want to check it out. So the first comment I wanted to share was, how many rejections did your account get? And this is the purpose of this video, trying to figure out like how many rejections can you get before your account gets closed. Now, in this case, they got 7 rejections in different niches. They said, I was beginner, which leads to the next thread, where they said that the person who started the thread, the poster, the OP, the original poster, said that they had about 130 sales really quickly on Merch by Amazon as a beginner, which is typically a red flag, guys. I mean, you know as well as I do, when people skyrocket to success, they are usually getting, I call it flying too close to the sun or cutting corners, you know what I mean? Towing the line a little too closely. We've seen a lot of that on Etsy, by the way, in the past. I've done some videos where I've shown shops that were like 2 months old, just went in, ripped off like every NFL team logo, every MLB team logo, and had like 2,000 sales in 2 months and racked up a bunch of money and then got their accounts eventually closed. But in the meantime, they made a bunch of money. Not saying you should do that, but I'm just saying typically when somebody is instantly successful, it's something along the lines of infringing on major brands' intellectual property. But we don't know in this case exactly what this person did to have their account shut down. If they're being truthful about 7 rejections, I would just like to share that, like, personally, I don't think there is a fixed number of rejections till you get your account closed. And I do think if there is a minimum threshold, or I guess it would be maximum threshold of rejections, I think it scales with your tier. So wouldn't that make sense? It would be like a function of your tier. So if you're in tier 10, I mean, this person said they had over 100 sales, but they didn't tell us what tier they were in. Let's just say he was in tier like 100. 7 rejections in tier 100 would not make a lot of sense, right? Because we would expect you'd be able to get away with a little bit more. And when I say get away with, I don't mean infringing on big brand intellectual property. I mean like, a fringe keyword upset the content policy. Hopefully you don't close my account. You get what I'm saying? Those are the more common rejections that I think are okay. So this person says, if you're getting 130 sales in 2 weeks on a new account, you're either a genius or in breach of copyright / trademark. And I mean, you can't help but agree there, because that is typically the case. The next comment, and this is, I guess this is in response, he said, you could have 120,000 sales instead of 120, mate. You're going to have zero tomorrow and the day after and the day after, which I think this is important just to highlight that, you know, guys, this is a long-term business model. We need to keep our accounts safe at all costs. It's not about making $100 today. It's about making $5 a day over the next 2 months, which will easily outpace the $100 tomorrow or $100 today that you make by putting your account at risk. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's better to make way less money over time, recurring, passively, and have your account alive than to risk everything for a short-term cash grab. Okay? And as far as the number of rejections, this pretty much illustrates what I really want to share. The same person that is posting that they were had their account closed had 2 days ago been asking if this design, which is a blatant ripoff of the Bass Pro Shop logo, by the way, I can't help but laugh. I mean, it is a pretty funny shirt design. But they were asking, like, is this okay? Which, by the way, please, guys, like, at least he asked in the group and didn't just, like, message me directly. Please, nobody message me directly. Is this niche okay? Because I honestly don't answer. Even if I know the answer, I don't answer. I make a point of saying I don't answer those types of questions because I just don't have, like, there's not enough time in the day. But anyways, if you're going to, like, make tweaks to some big brand logo and make a pretty funny shirt, but risk your account. Like, is it worth it? You know what I mean? Is it worth it? And then later on, he said he was asking for a friend, but like, do you think they were asking for a friend? I mean, they may have been genuinely asking for a friend, and it was the 7 rejections that had nothing to do with big brand logos being tweaked. What's more likely though? You know what I mean? I'm guessing that it had something to do with what I would call a major infringement. You know, when you infringe on big brand intellectual property, you're putting Amazon at risk. Because remember, on the front end of these listings, guys, they're sold by Amazon. So what do you think Amazon's gonna do? Do you think they care about, like, you or me? I'm in tier 200,000. Do you think they care about me? If they're gonna get a lawsuit, if I infringe on a big brand's logo and that brand decides to sue Amazon, of course they don't care about me. They're just gonna close my account immediately. So I do think there is a distinction between this sort of infringement, which you might as well just call, let's make up our own category. We'll call it the unforgivable kind, versus infringing on the content policy where some fringe keyword upset it and you got a what I would consider to be like a light rejection. Now, this is just me giving my 2 cents. I don't work for the merch team, so I don't know this for sure. Man, it would be great to be able to like have one of them on for an interview and just ask them how it works. But you know, who I'd really want to talk to would be like one of the engineers that actually wrote the algorithm. That would really be helpful. Or to know if this goes to like a manual decision maker's desk after the rejection to determine if they're just going to drop the hammer on your account. I don't know. You know, I mean, I know there's a lot of sellers, so I don't know how much manual reviewing they do or if it's all algorithmically policed. But what are your guys' thoughts in the comments below? Also, I should just mention, like, I've got over the course of the lifetime of my merch account, like, hundreds of rejections. Granted, there's different kinds, you know, I'm making this up as I go. Like, what do we call the type of rejection where you post one design, check every product type on every marketplace, and for some reason in Italy, I'm just making this up, Italy didn't like one of the translated keywords. So you got every product type rejected in Italy. Well, that's going to be 5 or 6 rejections to your total, right? So I don't know if there's like really a actual number. Obviously, the best practice is get as few as possible. Do your due diligence. I do have that one video called Is It Safe or Not? And I will go ahead and I'll link to it in the YouTube cards right here because that video is honestly the best video I've made as far as is something safe or not, because I show you how to validate it not only on the trademark database, but also doing merch by Amazon research, doing market research based on products that already exist. And then I think the next thread, okay, after this one, I'll show you something else that you can watch that'll really help you. But this person said, this is the last comment I wanted to share. They said, you did it once and you can do it again just the right way this time. Many other platforms to sell on. So they're trying to be respectful and positive in their response to the seller that was terminated, saying, hey, you know, you achieved success once already. You can do it again. There's other platforms you can sell on. It's not the end of the world to not be on Merch by Amazon. Obviously, it's ideal to be on Merch by Amazon because it, in my mind, has the highest earning potential. But there is plenty of other platforms, guys. And if you've been able to do it in one place, you can do it in another place. You should have honestly been doing it simultaneously in all the different places because you're leaving money on the table otherwise if you're not. But You know, and also if you're a beginner, it's okay to just do merch by Amazon and kind of, you know, the learning curve is steepest at the beginning of the journey. So it's okay. I forgive you. If you're only on merch by Amazon right now, but you're in the low tiers, it's all good. But as you get to tier 100, 500, 1000, make sure you branch out, take advantage of Etsy, eBay, Seller Central, Redbubble, at a minimum those. And then if you want to use upload automation, you can push to Spreadshirt, Teespring, Zazzle, Society6, TeePublic, Fine Art Society. I mean, lots of websites. Displate, there's a million. Before I leave you guys, I also wanted to recommend this video right here where I walk through the full content policy, because I know not everybody wants to read that thing. So why not put this video on in the background? Let me read it to you, okay? I will link to that in the YouTube cards right here as well. And I can drop links to the two videos in the description too, in case you want to go click them. Because the YouTube card thing kind of pops out and then goes away. So I'll drop links to both videos that I recommend watching in the description as well. Anyways, guys, that's it for this video. Make sure you take advantage of my free 7-day Merch by Amazon mini course in the description. By the way, I just went and updated it either yesterday or the day before. I don't remember. The weekends sometimes bleed together. I think it was 2 days ago. So it's updated a little bit. Also, I've got a full Merch by Amazon course taking you from tier 10 to tier 200,000. It's everything I learned along the way, taking my account from tier 10 to tier 200,000 over the last 4+ years. So highly recommended if you want to learn my exact processes. And it is tier-based. It's not just one size fits all. So check that out. Link in the description, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. I always have to remind you because I don't know. I need a reminder when I'm watching other people's videos. So please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon.